In this example, I'm going to look at what happens if we try direct geometric scale-up of a batch reactor that has heat transfer. And by geometric scale-up, I mean that we'll make the reactor 100 times larger, for example, while keeping the relative dimensions the same. So in this case, to make the calculations easy, I'm going to look at a case where the height of the reactor is equal to the diameter. In the drawing here, we're representing a batch reactor that has cooling jacket around it and the diameter D and the height D. And so we're going to look at scale from a small scale, 2/10 of a liter, then a factor 100 scale up to 20 liters, and then another factor 100 to 2,000 liters. These are just picked for convenience and not to suggest this is exactly how we'd want to do scale up. So liquid phase reaction, just A goes to B first order, given a rate constant, which of course has an exponential temperature dependence. We have heat capacities. We have a cooling temperature, the coolant circulating through the outer jacket. And we'll assume that temperature is constant just to make our calculations easy. We'll start out with the reactor at 50 degrees, but it's an exothermic reaction. So we're expecting temperature will increase, and we're given a heat transfer coefficient. So what we're going to assume is our heat transfer area is just the region connected by the jacket, assuming this is a circular tank, and we'll make some approximations here, but basically we'll say the area of the bottom, pi d squared over 4, plus the area of the sides completely, which would be pi d, the circumference, times the height. So this adds up to 1/4 plus 1 pi d squared. So this is going to be our area for heat transfer. The volume, of course, we're given, so we can calculate then the areas for each of these cases, and then we can calculate as our scale up how many moles we're going to put in the reactor for those conditions. And so we use the number of moles that we start with, 3 moles for the 0.2 liter tank, and therefore 300 moles for the 20 liter, and then 30,000 moles for the 2,000 liter tank. So we have our initial conditions. What we need are mass and energy balances that we're going to use along with these conditions. So first I've put a table here that puts the volume in cubic centimeters just so that we can be consistent with units. Calculate the diameter using the equation how volume relates to diameter for diameter and width being identical. Then calculate the area using this formula, and looked at the area to the volume ratio. So this is the important aspect in terms of what's happening as we scale up geometrically. The surface area for heat transfer, the volume goes down significantly. This is going to affect the temperature in the reactor. So to determine reactor temperature as a function of time, we're going to use first a mass balance, change in the total number of moles A, so NA is the total number of moles in reactor, as a function of time. It's a first order reaction, volume of the reactor, and our initial conditions at time equals zero, we're given NA is equal to NA zero for our first bench scale reactor, that number is 3 moles. And then we'll look at the energy balance, and in this case, because the heat capacities of the reactants and products are the same, and the 1 mole forms 1 mole, we can just write the contents as the initial number of moles of A, because that still equals the total number of moles at a later time, times the heat capacity of A, times the change in temperature with time. And that's changing for two reasons. We have a heat of reaction, we have a rate of reaction, minus KCA times V, and then we have a heat transfer coefficient, an area for heat transfer, and the coolant temperature minus the temperature. And we can check if the units look consistent, which indeed going through they are. We also can check if the signs are consistent. If the coolant temperature is lower than a reactor temperature, then the temperature is going to decrease with time. Exothermic reaction, so this is a negative number. This is negative. This term is negative. So as reaction proceeds, overall, this is positive, and so the temperature will increase due to reaction. So now we want to solve these two equations simultaneously, where the other initial condition is at T equals zero, time equals zero, the temperature is 50 degrees C, and then we'll convert everything to Kelvin because we need to use Kelvin in our rate constant here. So what I'm showing here is the polymath program that's used to solve the differential equations. We're given first term, first equation is the energy balance and initial temperature in Kelvin. Mass balance, this is for the smallest reactor, so we start out with 3 moles. And then the various parameters, this is volume in cubic centimeters. We'll integrate from time equals 0 to 40 minutes, and that's because checking, knowing already the answer, that's a reasonable time to demonstrate the behavior we're interested in. And we calculate the concentration from the number of moles and the volume. We need that concentration in our rate expression. And the coolant temperature also in Kelvin, keeping everything consistent. So I'm showing 4 graphs here. For the smallest reactor, the cooling actually overwhelms the heat of reaction. And so on that scale, we have enough surface area, the temperature actually continually decreases. And therefore, of course, reaction is very slow. We go to the next largest size, 20 liters. Now we get a significant isotherm up to approximately 400 degrees Kelvin as the high temperature. Whereas we go to the 2,000 liter size, now we get a much more dramatic. So trying to scale from 0.2 of a liter to 2,000 liters using geometric scale up certainly would not predict the behavior just from a direct scale up. Instead, 0.2 of a liter, the temperature decreases. Whereas for 2,000 liters, the temperature increases. And then for comparison, this is the adiabatic case where there's no cooling at all. And you can see for the 2,000 liter case, we approach close to the adiabatic temperature before reaction slows down and we start cooling. So this is something we have to keep in mind, this effect of surface area for heat transfer to reaction volume and scaling up a batch reactor.